dying with this.
Your money.
A millionaire, I'm a young money millionaire, tougher than Nigerian hair. My criteria compared to your career just isn't fair. I'm a venereal disease, like a menstrual bleed through the pencil and leak on the sheet of the tablet in my mind. Cause I don't write, cause I ain't got time. Cause my seconds, minutes, hours go to the almighty dollar in the almighty power of that chopper. Sister, brother, son, daughter, father, motherfucker, copper. Got the Maserati dancing on the bridge.
You are probably wondering how I got to where I am right now with all of this dough. It is a long story, but I will tell you anyway. It all started when I was a young, vulnerable, and small freshman. I was in search of sustained involvement in something unique and what have you. Yes, Mr. Nielsen, I'm making fun of you. So that I can make my mark in the greater Santa Barbara community. To be completely honest, I struggled very much with this. No matter how hard I tried or how long I searched, I always came up empty-handed. Due to this significant roadblock, I decided to talk things through with my father. After about an hour-long conversation, we came up with the idea to make our own website, and the main goal of the site would be to match high school students with nonprofit organizations in search of volunteers. And because I'm a generous person and knew that this would look good on college apps, I decided to add my brother to the committee. However, my main goal is not to use this solely to look good on college apps, because I know some people, Adam, would do that. I, on the other hand, truly wanted to better Santa Barbara. We initially thought that we were going to do this by ourselves and use our own website through a company named ChapterWeb. However, a couple hours into our search, we came across Volunteer Match, which had stolen our idea and 20 years ago too. Some people might have stopped there, but us Fay boys did not. That is not how Matt and Sherry Fay raised us. Instead, we kept going. We persevered through this hardship. We called Volunteer Match to see if we could create some sort of partnership. Of course, they said yes, as if they had not, I would not be making this documentary. Volunteer Match let us leverage their SaaS model, which stands for Software as a Service. What you see now is actually Santa Barbara High School's Give Back site that is used by over 3,000 students in the Santa Barbara Unified School District. However, this was just the beginning. We still had a long road ahead of us. Our next steps required a lot of time and effort. We had to research all of the nonprofits in Santa Barbara and input all of their contact information into a spreadsheet, which now has 600 plus organizations on it. We then used the spreadsheet as a to-do list. Whenever we had the chance, Nate and I would go out throughout Santa Barbara to meet with nonprofits to get them registered on Santa Barbara High School's Give Back. This was by far and away the most influential aspect of this entire project, because it has made me a very comfortable public speaker and has taught me how to communicate professionally with people through email, phone calls, and face-to-face confrontations. Realizing the amount of work this would take, we added two more people to our committee, Andrew Giller and John Henry Cronin. While all of this was going on, I was in contact with Mr. Barrett and our career counselor, Mrs. Gaeta, trying to set up a meeting so that we could present our idea to them in order to get approval. They were thrilled with our project and immediately put us through to former superintendent, Dr. Cash, who was also enamored by Santa Barbara High School's Give Back. This ultimately led to Nate and me presenting to the Santa Barbara Unified School District Board for final approval. With a unanimous decision, we were granted full approval to implement Santa Barbara High School's Give Back throughout the district. Unfortunately, a lot of good things come with a price. In this case, it was $5,000 each year. For the very first year, we agreed to raise the money to pay for the cost, and then the district would pay for the rest of the years to come. To fund this first year of production, we applied for and received a grant from the Moser Foundation. Now came the most difficult part, student registration. We tried and failed many times to register students on Santa Barbara High School's Give Back at San Marcos last spring. It was not until this fall that we had full success in doing so. Our most successful strategy was to target the freshmen and sophomores because they are vulnerable little children that will do anything the big and intimidating seniors and juniors will tell them to do. We did not give seniors and juniors any attention because seniors don't care enough, and juniors for the most part already have or are on track to reaching their community service requirement. We got all of these students registered by going to every freshman health class and every sophomore world history class with Chromebook and iPad cards. We still have a lot of work to do, but we have officially started to launch at both Santa Barbara High School and Dos Pueblos High School, thanks to the help of our newly added representatives, Jack Sipes from DP and Michael Machido from SB. Along with them, we have also added Sean Russo and Jasper Yost from DP, and Chase Nelson and Max Gold from SB to help launch this wonderful tool throughout the district. Within the past month or so, I passed the torch down to Nate so that he could take my position as leader when I go off to Cal Poly next year. Go Mustangs, am I right? Due to the fact that Nate will be graduating next year, we have also been in the process of recruiting freshmen and sophomores interested in joining the committee so that we can prolong the impact of Santa Barbara High School's give back. That pretty much sums up how I got to where I am today. It might have required a lot of time and effort, but has become some of the most influential work I've ever done. Not only have I helped students impact the community that surrounds them, I've helped the nonprofits throughout all of Santa Barbara receive helping hands from high schoolers, and I've matured as a human being. If you personally want to visit the Santa Barbara High School's Give Back website, go to sbunified.volunteermatch.org. Thank you, and have a nice day.